Ableton Live is a type of music production software, commonly referred to as a digital audio workstation, or DAW. You can purchase three different tiers of Ableton Live: Intro, Standard, and Suite, each unlocking more features than the last. There is also, however, a fourth form of Ableton called Ableton Live Lite, which is a special version made specifically to be bundled with music hardware, such as MIDI controllers or audio interfaces. This is a basic, lightweight variant of Ableton, but can be quite powerful once you learn how to use it. So in this video, I just wanted to take some time and break down what all it is you can do in each version of Ableton. Real quick, I wanted to give a shout out to this video's sponsor, Skillshare. They are an online learning community, so if this video leaves you wanting to learn more, then click the link in the description below where you can get started with a free 2-month trial. Stick around until the end of this video to learn more details, but for now, let's break down what all it is you can do with each version of Ableton. So once you receive your license to Ableton, you can go to their website and you can download, install, and register your product. From here, if you open up your DAW, you're faced with a window that looks like this. If you're looking to learn the interface and get started with arranging your own music, consider checking out this tutorial I made a few months ago, where I explain how to use this software, starting from opening it for the very first time and ending with clicking export on your first song. Since that's already out there in the world, the direction I'd like to take with this video is more so explaining the features in Ableton Live Lite and comparing that to Ableton Live Intro, Standard, and Suite. For all intents and purposes, Ableton Live Lite is most similar to Ableton Live Intro. So, firstly, let's go down the list of what features Ableton Live Lite has to offer. If you'd like to follow along and view this page for yourself, I'll leave a link in the description below. In addition, you can also go through and compare the other versions of Ableton by going to Ableton's website, clicking on the Live tab, and then Compare Editions. And we should soon see a list of bullet points that looks familiar. As I mentioned earlier, for the most part, Ableton Live Lite is most similar to Intro. You can compare the key features side by side to see the differences for yourself, but I believe the main differences are the number of layers you can use, and we'll explain more of this later, and you do get a few more audio effects in Ableton Intro. The main thing to remember is Lite was bundled with hardware that you bought, and Ableton Intro would be a standalone software that you buy. Anyways, going through the list of key features, there are plenty of bullet points that use fancy vernacular to explain what it is each version can do. For the most part, the bullet points at the top of this list are the same across all versions, and they're just breaking down what it is you can do in Ableton Live. In short, it's a DAW. You can arrange layers, slice samples, and export music. Cool. Where the main differences start to come in, however, are about midway through, when we hit audio and MIDI tracks. These are the maximum number of combined audio and MIDI layers you can use simultaneously in any given Ableton Live project. You can see in Ableton Intro, the number is capped at 16, which means you can't use any more than 16 layers of instruments or audio tracks combined. It's worth noting this is one of the differences between Ableton Lite and Intro, because in Ableton Live Lite, you are instead limited to a maximum number of 8 combined tracks in any given Ableton session. Now, this is more than enough if you're using your music hardware to play live sessions, say, as an instrument for a jam session. But yes, if you are planning to go beyond and use Ableton to arrange your music, the 8-layer maximum starts to become a hurdle. You can see in Ableton Standard and Suite, there is no cap for the number of layers you can use. Similarly, the number of scenes is capped for Ableton Lite and Intro to 8. These are used to loop MIDI clips or audio samples on repeat, intended for live performances. Send and return tracks are used if you find yourself using a common set of audio effects on every single layer. You can instead place all the audio effects on a send track, and then route all your desired layers to that processing bus. You can see Ableton Lite and Intro are limited to a max number of 2 send and return tracks, whereas Standard and Suite have a cap of 12. You are also limited to a maximum of 8 audio inputs and outputs in Lite and Intro, but can go up to 256 in Standard and Suite. And finally, you can see you don't have access to Max for Live in any version except for Suite. This is a powerful jack-of-all-trades software you can use to customize or build your own devices in Ableton. From here, you can see there are now only key features available to Standard and Suite. These are features such as being able to use complex warp modes. Audio to MIDI is pretty pretty cool. This lets you drag an audio sample onto a MIDI track, and then Ableton will convert the sound it hears into MIDI notes. There are also plenty of other cool features I suggest you look into yourself, but for the most part, that's it on the features. So, quick recap. So far, essentially all the versions of Ableton do the same thing. They're all built on the same exact software. The main differences are that Lite and Intro are generally limited on the number of tracks you can use, and Standard and Suite have a few more cool bells and whistles. So now we get into more of the bigger differences, being the tools that are provided with each version. In Ableton Live Lite, you're given access to 4 built-in software instruments. These are what power our MIDI layers. In Ableton Intro, you're also given access to the same 4 instruments, but in Standard and Suite, you unlock much more. This provides a greater variety of sounds. Lite and Intro get the job done, but having more instruments to play around with allows you to better customize your sounds. As we go down the list, you see a pattern of the different tools available in the different versions of Ableton. Suite provides you with a bunch more sample packs. This gives you access to a larger library of audio samples you can download from Ableton's site. Suite and Standard also give you access to more audio effects. These allow you to modify any layer of audio or MIDI to tweak your sounds to your liking. At the time of recording this video, Ableton Lite gives you 12 audio effects, Intro gives you 21, Standard 34, and Suite gives you 55. Similarly, you get more MIDI effects with the higher versions of Ableton. These allow you to alter your MIDI notes directly to create more unique sounds. If you're curious, all versions of Ableton give you the same 8 fundamental MIDI effects. Then Ableton Suite goes above and beyond, providing you with 17. And that does it for comparing the different versions of Ableton. Now on to the big question I'm sure most of you may be thinking. Which version of Ableton should I get? And the honest to goodness, objective truth, it depends. As much of a cop-out answer that is, it's really the truth depending on what you plan on using this software for. You should only ever get Ableton Lite if you get access to it through purchasing some type of music hardware, say a MIDI controller. If you only ever plan on using the software to power your controllers and use this as a lightweight tool to amp up your live jam sessions, I'd recommend keeping it. The features given to you by the higher paid tiers of Ableton won't add much to your workflow and may not be worth it. However, if you didn't purchase any music hardware and are looking at which version of Ableton to use as an independent software, maybe that gets a little trickier. If this is the case, you're most likely interested in pursuing music production, and the limiting amount of tracks you can use in Ableton Intro are gonna be a major roadblock in your work. Ableton Standard and Suite are perfect for music production, with Ableton Suite coming out on top ever so slightly. Now, the differences between Standard and Suite are minor in terms of features, but Suite grants you a significant amount more sounds and effects out of the gate. Suite is probably the best call for you if you know for an absolute fact that you'll use the software and the tools provided a crazy amount. Otherwise, if music production is more of a casual hobby and you want all the features without being held back, but don't want to spend all the money on Suite, my personal opinion is you should go with Ableton Standard. For the record, I personally own Suite, and I don't regret it. One last thing, it's worth mentioning, if you're a student or a teacher, you can get a pretty significant discount, so consider looking into that. And there you have it, that's the breakdown between the different versions of Ableton Lite, Intro, Standard, and Suite. If you want to keep the ball rolling and learn more about music production, consider checking out this video's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators, and viewers of my channel will love what they have to offer. You just heard my breakdown on the different versions of Ableton, and now you can take that one step further and learn how to make music from certified professionals. And you can do so by checking out one of the more than 25,000 classes Skillshare has to offer on topics such as music, design, technology, and more. Skillshare's premium membership gives you unlimited access, so you can join whichever community you so desire, drop in and out of lessons, and overall, master exactly what it is you've set out to learn. Plus, Skillshare is super affordable. An annual subscription comes down to be less than $10 a month. And on top of that, if you use the link in the description below, you will get a 2-month free trial. So join the more than 7 million creators learning with Skillshare today. Whether you want to fuel your curiosity, creativity, or even career, Skillshare is the perfect place to keep you learning and thriving in today's modern world. Thank you so much for supporting this video and channel, Skillshare. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, maybe found it helpful. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Bye.